today from Mauritania. Dahan Baida is the man in charge. His assistants are from Angola and Zambia. And the video assistant referee, Mahmoud Ashour, is Egyptian. So, Cote d'Ivoire, two changes for them as well from the semi-final, when they have no fewer than four players suspended. Aurier and Kusunu return. In goal for MS Faye's team is Yahya Fofana. Had a good tournament, played all the minutes of every game so far. As in the back four has Evan Ndika of Roma, the only outfield player to have done that. Aurier and Kusunu were both banned for the semi. As I say, that must have been an agonizing watch for them. In midfield, Frank Kessier went to Barcelona and Milan. Scored a late equalising penalty, we saw it earlier, to keep his side in the tournament against Senegal in the round of 16. Up front, Sebastien Haller came good with a semi-final winner over DR Congo, but Brighton's Simon Adinga, there's been the real impact player, starting the tournament on the bench, injury permitting. I think it's unlikely Adinga will be left out of the 11 again anytime soon. There is the man for whom history awaits. Jose Pesero and MS Faye, the two coaches, and alongside me, Efan Akoki. Does this bring back memories, Efan? 1994, El Menza Stadium in Tunis, Nigeria, Zambia, and you won the trophy.
It certainly does, Steve. Memories are long, but still quite sweet. And I can really appreciate what the squad is going through for both sides. But especially for Nigeria, of course, expectancy is always super high for the Super Eagles, but it can't be any more than it is for these Ivorian players. So what a fantastic occasion.
It certainly is, and the referee blows the whistle, and it is Nigeria, all in green, of course, against the Ivory Coast.